हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 ऑफ सेल्फ प्रैक्टिस 11B, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 ऑफ सेल्फ प्रैक्टिस 11B. नाउ इन 11B, शो बाय कंपेयरिंग एंगल्स एंड साइड विच ऑफ द ट्रायंगल हियर आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू ईच अदर. ओके, विच ऑफ द ट्रायंगल आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू ईच अदर. नाउ सी हियर in A5, second A5, in triangle ABC and triangle ABC, DEF and triangle PQR, okay? So you can see that BC is equal to EF. Is equal to QR. Okay, all the sides are equal. Angle A is angle B is equal to angle E is equal to angle Q. The last one, angle A is not equal to angle D. Angle F is equal to angle P. So here angle A is not equal. So hence triangle DEF is congruent to triangle PQR. Okay, triangle DEF is congruent to triangle PQR. Now B part. Angle S is not equal to angle C equal to angle P equal to angle L. Okay, only angle S is not equal to, and then angle D is equal to angle Q is equal to angle T. Is equal to angle M. Now SD is equal to OC is equal to TR is equal to LM. Okay. So from here what you see? Only at one place one angle is not equal to other. So triangle SBD is not congruent to OCOG, PTR and KLM. So which are congruent to each other? Triangle COG is congruent to triangle PTR is congruent to triangle KLM. Okay? Means the last three are congruent to each other, but the first one is not congruent to each other. Correct? Now see the C part. Now see here in all the four triangles, you see last one is 60 degree. But one more thing, you know, all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So here this circle means 30 degree, correct? Here you can see all the four triangles are congruent to each other because all are having the same measurement. Is it or not? But here hypotenuse is not given. In RHS we want one hypotenuse. So you can see two triangles are being given and one side. So when two triangles and two angles and one side are given, then it is said to be as ASA congruence. The RHS congruence it is. RHS congruence. Okay. This one is about RHS congruence. Triangle XYZ is congruent to triangle OGH and is also congruent to triangle PMA and it is also congruent to triangle SUM because all the four triangles here are having the same length and same angles. So that side is all the four triangles are congruent to each other. Now see the last part of it, D part. In last part of it, that is D part. 60 degree, 70 degree. How much? 5 cm. Then 70 degree, 60 degree. Then this is how much? 5 cm. Now, here what you can see, in first, second and third, the side and two angles are equal to each other. See, in first, second only, all the angles and sides are equal but not in third and fourth. Which two are congruent to each other? First and second means, triangle CDE is congruent to triangle BQS. And other all, they are different. Somewhere angle and somewhere side are different. So only how many are together equal? Only two triangles are equal to each other. Okay students? So this is about the congruency of a triangle. Now let's see question number 3. So what is there in question number 3? In question number 3, in the following figure, state the condition you would use to show that triangle ABC and triangle CDE are congruent. So by which you can show? Now see, in triangle ABC and triangle CDE, angle C is equal to angle C. Vertically opposite angle, so they will be equal to each other. AC is equal to CE and BC is equal to CD. So by SAS congruence, these two are equal to each other. By SAS congruence they are equal to each other. Now see in the figure question number 4. See question number 4.
What is there? In the figure I've given alongside ABCD is a rhombus. Are ADC, ABC congruent? And what you can say about AB, D and BC, D? ADC and ABC are congruent to each other. So you can say when triangle ABC is congruent to triangle BCD, then triangle ABD is also congruent to triangle ABD is also congruent to triangle PCD. Okay, they will be also congruent to each other. After that, what you can say, ABD is congruent to BCD as all sides of rhombus are equal. As all sides of rhombus are equal, and the diagonal intersect at 90 degrees. Intersect at 90 degrees. Means they will be also equal to each other because diagonals are equal and they intersect each other at 90 degrees. Okay, student? Okay, thank you and have a good day. That's all for today.